Last two bars of 48. Yeah, bring it into 49. Call out down this. My cue. two bars before we come into the Alleluia. Dantes Dominum, Dantes.
What happened if when you got to that bar of the duple? You feel a lifting rather than a one. You have to be clear.
Okay.
Right?
Okay,
yeah.
Sure. Why don't we start from Gola Dun Domino from the 6th up, pick up to 3 bars before the Alleluia, so we are right on top of 49. Call out on this domino.
By flicking your wrist down, and if you eliminate that, I think that would help with the clarity.
Okay.
For the duple.
Yeah. Anytime.
Okay. Anytime. All right. Good. Anything else?
Yeah. I don't know how to use that word. Do you like it's like rhythm, but it's not the rhythm about the tempo. It's the rhythm about
internal motion.
Yeah, like that. Just
the character of the rhythm?
I think sometimes his rhythm like change a little bit, so I can get pretty clear. So if he can keep his maybe rhythm thing.
Yes.
So
oh, the pulse? The pulse?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, Rudong.
Rudong. I'm not sure that word. I don't think so.
I don't really know what it, yeah. Something
like okay.
It feels like, it feels like, call out on the but sometimes
it
will change like. Sometimes.
Well, he's doing a proportion. I see what you're saying.
Yes, yes.
You want the coordinate to stay the same. He's doing a different
proportion. Tempo maintenance.
Light bulb.
Tempo maintenance. Yes.
Okay.
I don't know if I can remember that.
That's right.
So I think actually you're doing the a different proportion. He's not doing the quarter note is not staying the same. But the other thing that good comments. I think the other thing that might help with the body is to think about the change in character for the sparkly Alleluia. One, two, three, la, ba, maybe a little bit more less sustained.
And even.
Because you said you wanted it to be more articulate, right?
Articulate,
so maybe a little bit faster rebound at the very start, but keep it free. So let's try that. What if we did one, two, one, two? Do you see how the speed of the rebound is pretty much the same, right? But one, what if we kept the same tempo and made it just a little bit more pingy on the bing, two, so that you feel the the lift. Does that feel different? I see what you're saying, Alex, in one for the cola da. Yeah, so see if you can keep this on line.
Aligned.
Yeah, good. Do we have 2 minutes? Five?
Six.
Six minutes? Oh, all right. Any other comments for Yuhan?
Yes. In the last three bars, I think it might be helpful to go into four a little bit earlier, or just to subdivide a little bit earlier for us to catch the slowdown in the ultimate bar. It feels really hard to catch the pulse there. And then my other thought, sort of piggybacking off what Alex said, is that I think sometimes the actual ichthys, the point of the ichthys, have a lot more weight than the rest of your gestus, so you get this sort of
it's like stopping a bar.
I don't know whether it's stopping, but I feel like the ichthys
you're punching it.
It has a lot more weight than the rest of the gesture. So even when we're getting this sort of like big, instead of really feeling like the ichthys is a jumping off point, it feels almost like, you know, that like it is attracting more weight, and maybe that's part of what is hard about navigating the near change.
Yeah, good thought.
I know this is a lot all the time. For me personally, I think a gesture of syncopation into the would help, just because with your changing of the proportion, or not, I'm not quite sure. And I think because our notes are so agile, I would love to see more of a consistent foundation from you of just kind of like a metronome for a moment while we just kind of get our bearings for that session.
Yeah, and to piggyback off of that, I think just for the first bar, when we switch into that two, I would do one of two things. At least early in the rehearsal process, I might actually do that first bar in four, just so that it's extremely clear. Or if you keep it in two, like, I think that this like lilting is great character, but for that first bar, we really need to be able to calculate just on a very clear, like, consistent speed, so that we can really see and do the subdivision in our head. And then after that bar transition, then you can switch into the more character, like, you know.
Okay.
That yeah. Kind of, and do you remember that Yuhang actually conducted that the first time in the first round in four, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we were perfectly together, but the proportions were off, right?
Yeah.
So you were going like way slower for that. So this is the challenge for conductors. If you want the proportion that he wants, which is dotted half note equals half note, it's easier as a conductor to train ourselves to do, this is a pulse, one, two, da, one, two, ti, half, right? But then if you do one, two, ti, one, two, ti, one, then you have to have such a clear idea and feeling of what that half is so that you can subdivide the half, which is really hard. So should we try that?
Yeah,
let's
sure.
Let's try that. Okay, so
should
everybody
I try
together.
That in four in this section, or should I stay in two?
I would stay in two, but subdivided two, but I want everybody to feel that, how hard that is. Okay, so let's do, how about the top of 48?
48, sure.
Yeah.
This do, me.
Okay, everybody conducting, when you get to the 4-4 at the very bottom, keep it in two, but show the one. But a subdivided two so that you show the second quarter note. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so here's 48 at the top. One, two, T, go, two, T. Almost like place that one and regroup and take a rhythmic breath on the end. One, bum bum ba dum ba da, and then not delay. Bum bum ba dum. Ah, and then when you get into two, follow through. One, ba two, follow through.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. Let's try again from the same spot, right on 48.
Okay,
Let's try Gola Dante in the second time, 15.
I feel like sometimes the second beat, especially the 4-4 bars, are kind of left alone, like they're left out in a way, and we're always prepping for like the third beat or something like that. But a lot of the times people have entrances on that second beat, mm-hmm. and then they're kind of lost, and then the tempo gets off for a split second, and I feel like that would be really helpful. If, I don't really know what to do, I don't know how to solve that problem, but like if that was given a little bit more attention.
Yeah.
Like,
really good thought. And can you give me a measure?
Well, specifically, I'm looking at the top of 51, the
yeah.
last measure.
Ah, right. Buff, buff,
and
buff,
the first measure
one,
that is
buff.
Two. Yeah.
So maybe if you, when you're doing the one, buff, buff, you're going to breathe with the bass in ba, dum, ba, 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 bum, ba, dum, you know, left hand or something. That's
okay.
One more thing. Good catch. Yeah.
I think I found a new way to describe it. It's like, I feel like it's not even.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you change from 3 to 4, if you play it even,
mm-hmm.
and we can feel the rhythm, so we won't play it like fast or something, but sometimes you come to like, and your rebound is not even, so we can feel the rebound, and can find the beats like that, the rhythm. So I think it's even thing if you can try to make it even.
In the space,
yeah.
Yeah,
just the rebound, you can continue to move and it even.
Mm-hmm. With
and
even energy.
Yeah, and it will not break in any rhythm thing.
Okay, great. And so I think that was probably operative at the top of 51 as well, which is probably really well. Yeah.
I feel like when we change to, like from 4-4 to 3-4, like we tend to like speed up a little bit. That's why the proportion is not like deep or oh my god, keep that. But that's what we did.
I actually feel the opposite, which is that whenever we switch to 4-4, we slow down. And then
yeah.
we go back to 3-4
yeah.
and you're back in
yeah.
tempo.
Well, so this is the whole the proportion thing, right? Mm-hmm. The sesquialtera, and I think I mentioned Ruth DeFord and her book, which is very thick, all on top to rhythm and mensuration in the Renaissance, in early music. And basically, lots of factors determined how conductors chose these meter changes, right? So one thought is, what's most of all sesquialtera is that the dotted half note, one, equals the half note. So then that would make the quarter note slow down, but not as much as you did
okay.
on some of them.
Mm-hmm.
But at 51, definitely, top of 51, it was really, I think you felt it, mm-hmm. and you were using less space, and it was lighter,
okay.
And the articulation. So, you know, so much has to do with how we hear the character, I think, rather than just, you know, like trying to be exact in technique. Any other thoughts? Good ideas for you, huh? The beep went off a couple minutes ago.
Yeah.
Keep going with that. It's a lot. So the next step, I think, is just to get more character and more contrast between the sections. Okay. Yes, good job.